Right now, the market vendor.
Yes, it is me, market vendor, here again today. But listen, the talk of the town over the last couple of days was, of course, what happened in the Senate just a few days ago. And you see me, market vendor, the issues really get lost in all the crosstalk. Now, the purpose of that meeting largely, apparently, was to pass integrity legislation. Legislation that all during the years of the BLP between 94 and 2008 we wanted but didn't get. Legislation on integrity that between 2008 and 2018 when the DLP was in power that we did not get. And finally, the legislation that we all have been craving for and wanting to see come to pass after the last government was in power for 10 years and did nothing about it is finally passed in the lower house. Makes its way into the upper chamber and is defeated in the upper chamber because of the numbers. Now, just for the records, as I understood it, all 10 members of the government side who were present voted for the bill. But yet, the leader of the opposition party, called the DLP, is saying that the government of the day is not really committed to passing the bill. I gotta ask myself, market, where the logic is in that though, huh? Well, your government was in power for 10 years, and when it did nothing, this government brings it to Parliament, drafts it after consultation, wide consultation, brings it to Parliament, pass in Parliament, it gone out to the Senate, all the government people in the Senate on the day in question voted for it, eh? And you're going to blame the government because the legislation ain't going to pass and say that they're not committed to it? Oh, loss. Really, I think logically, you would have to lay that claim at the feet of the other people who were there and who did not vote for the bill. It's a logical kind of thing. You understand where market coming from? Surely those who voted against it or those who maybe abstained from it or those who walked out from it, surely you could put that claim at them and maybe not even so because their reasons for walking out may have been different as we heard. Now we get to the matter of Senator Cummings. You see me, market vendor, I don't have to defend this good senator because she did an eloquent job of defending that herself. Now let us be very clear. She was present when the Ghanaian workers arrived here in Barbados. She did not go and hug them up and all kinds of things. She took a precautionary measure and self-isolated. You understand? She also had a test which was negative. The chief medical officer gave her clearance. Two doctors inside the House of Parliament explained the circumstances that she was never a COVID patient. So at the end of the day, don't listen to the doctors. You see me? I was just an orderly. I was a receptionist. That way, the doctor tell you, okay. Oh, okay. Well, listen, I read a lot of books by the net, you know. I know a little bit about medicine and things too as well. All right, with me, you know. Let me tell you something. Listen to me, man. I know more about medical things than them. Who are we really going to listen to? You're going to listen to the layperson? You're going to listen to hysteria? Look, I don't have to defend a good senator, as I said. The senator is quite capable of doing that for herself. You understand where market coming from? But to me, all of this, the issues are really being lost at the end of the day. And all the hyperbole and the hysteria ain't going to get me nowhere. You see me, market vendor. I can go with the experts. If the medical doctor said that you are okay, if your tests are okay, well, I don't see what the problem is. Isn't that the same standard that we apply to people coming into Barbados? Say, market vendor, gone for now. But you have a blessed and a wonderful day. I intend to. You hear?